Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making tortellini carbonara, and I think you'll enjoy that along with the breadsticks that we made earlier. So I'm going to show you the bag that I got my tortellini in. I don't make this by hand. I don't make any pasta by hand. I wouldn't ask you to do that either. And most of us find this at the grocery store in different flavors, and you can make it very quickly from these packs. Now in this pack we have seasoned beef and ricotta and Romano cheeses. So you just look on the back and look at the instructions for preparing it. Follow the instructions, because your instructions might be different from mine. It would depend on the brand. So mine is already cooked. I went ahead and I followed the instructions and I drained this after it got cooked. So now what we're going to do is start a little sauce. Over here I have 2 tablespoons of butter, and I have it hot so that I can put my chopped garlic in. I'm going to use this spoon right here. It's finely chopped garlic, not quite minced, but minced will be fine. And it's 2 cloves. So we're going to put that into our heated butter, 2 tablespoons of butter. And I'll turn the heat up so you will see it sizzle. I think, there we got it. And I need to cook this until it's soft. So it's going to take 30 seconds to a minute, and I'll be back. Here's our softened garlic, and actually it's taking on a little bit of a tan color. You don't want to let it burn. If it turns black, then you need to throw that out and start again, because that would be considered burned. And even as it remains in a hot skillet, it can continue to cook. So I'm going to go ahead and mix this up. My tortellini that I have cooked is 19 ounces uncooked. So if you're wondering how much to get, this was one package, just one size of package that it comes in. So I'm going to go ahead and coat that with the butter and garlic to stop that garlic from cooking. Then we have a few more ingredients to stir in. The first one here is bacon, and it's bacon that has already been fried, and I have crisped it up in the microwave, and it was 8 slices. So generally that's a half pound. Usually you can get 16 slices in a pound, but you need it crumbled. So after getting it all crisp, I use my fingers to just crumble it up, 8 slices worth. Put that in. Now I'll just put in some of these things and then do a stirring. And now I'm adding 2/3 of a cup of finely grated Parmesan cheese. We grate this by hand. It's so much fresher and tastes so much better. So I'll be stirring that in. Now also I have whipping cream, and this is 1/2 cup. So 4 ounces you'll see on this little glass. We'll pour that in. And I think it's time for me to stir this before I put in my last 3 ingredients. So you just want to get a good coating over your tortellini. And it's beginning to look really good. I really love the sauce. And when we eat this with, actually if you use a nice green salad and those Parmesan mini breadsticks, it's really going to be a great meal. Okay, the other things we have, and this is still fresh from our garden of last year. So we have 2 tablespoons of chopped parsley, and it's fairly coarsely chopped. 2 tablespoons that you would wash and dry with a paper towel, and then take kitchen scissors and just chop it up. If you don't have fresh parsley, which most people won't in the United States, northern United States at least, then you can use dry parsley. Just make sure you use only 1/3 as much, because it's very intense if it's dried. And then I'm going to put a little bit of black pepper. Just grind some black pepper over the top. It would be a total of about 1/2 teaspoon. And that's it, except for any garnish that I might have. So I'm going to get a nice plate, and I'll get my breadsticks out and display all of that for you and take a taste for you. So I've got my dishes out and I'm ready to serve this up on a platter. So I've chose a fairly small platter, well, a medium size platter, and you'll just pour this out in the center there. And you see it's just creamy enough to coat really well. You don't want it soupy, but you do want it definitely to coat well. So we pour that out, and then I will try to corral some of these that we're trying to go over the edge. And then I have a little bit of parsley, which I'm going to put in a corner somewhere. Make it look a little fresher and more inviting. And then if you would like, you can take any cheese that you might have left over. I had this left over actually from making the breadsticks. It was already grated, so you might want to put some of that over the top, and you might want to offer that each individual person some extra. But here we have it. This is our tortellini carbonara, and I hope you enjoy it. I'm going to serve myself some of the tortellini carbonara, and it's nice to have something to toss it with if it's had a chance to sit for any time, which this really hasn't, but it's also easy to serve it if you want to like that, but I think I'll just manage with this fork here and bring it over to my plate and just get a nice serving. I want to get some of everything, of course, so I'll go for the bacon as well as plenty of parsley, and it should be mixed pretty well already, so shouldn't be any problem with that. So here's actually a big serving for me. This does make four servings, the amount that I made. And then I'm going to choose a breadstick over here, this nice brown crispy one. And then I'll give myself a little bit of Parmesan cheese on top. And then I'll just treat myself to a little bit of garnish. It's not much, but this is the last of our herb garden probably, and you won't be seeing much more of it. So I'm making as much use of it as I possibly can. So there's my plate. So we just take this little bite because it has some of everything. And normally I would eat it with bread. And I'm testing for flavor. I actually didn't get any bacon with that bite. You know I love bacon, so going back. And I'll take that size bite. The bacon makes it. Some of you don't eat bacon. You can use bacos as a substitute. You can use dried beef if you want to. It will not necessarily be called carbonara, but you can make some substitutions where you would be happy with it without using bacon. But I think Rick and I will enjoy our dinner tonight because this is a pasta dish, and we always look forward to when we have pasta at night. So I hope you have a chance to try the recipe, and I hope that you will enjoy this dish.